Every generation will not be confused. There is a generation that will get this thing. From that day, the creative dimension of the prophetic.
There must be a performance because.
These words. Are we together now? And then a few years ago, I was praying, and this is when I confronted a spirit that I want to talk to you about. I was praying and crying that God will bless and lift his people. Then all of a sudden, my ceiling just shifted, and standing before me was this creature. The eyes was as big as the head of a man. Like, imagine that. And then the tail, it looked like a dinosaur. But the tail had its own life. I'm just sharing with you an experience. Are we together now? And it was looking at me with fierce anger, red eyes. And it says, so you think you can bring God's people into financial blessings? That was my conversation with that spirit. When that thing happened, my life entered a dimension of wealth. I said, what is this? What is the mystery? What is this one again? There are decisions that we make that keep us poor, but there are spirits. It is true. Are we together? This is what he's looking for. Your soul. Not your money. Not your bank account. You've heard the popular statement that they sold their souls to the devil. It's not a lie, and it's not a proverb. It is true. You don't sell your soul to the devil by meeting him and say, devil, take. No. If you intend to rise to a level where you become one who is a pillar for the coming revival, you can learn about prayer, you can learn about fasting. If you miss this lecture, you will pay for it, I guarantee you. You see what is happening? School fees is increasing. Parents, talk to me. House rent. Land. We were having a discussion at lunch with Pastor and his wife, and he was telling me of the price for one plot of land in this your area. I said, that's why people are angry. You see someone talking to himself alone and just moving, and he's angry, and you say, are you okay? Why will I be okay? You know, all that kind of thing. I mean, you see it happen. People talk on the street, even when they are sleepy. That's how far depression can go when you reconfigure a human being to become something else. The concentration of members is less than 10 minutes. If they give you 10 minutes, their mind, they are looking at you, but they are not there again. Let me tell you the truth. I'm not just trying to make you laugh. These are serious issues. The top three reasons statistically confirmed why marriages fail. Number one is money and money related issues. Number two, intimacy issues. Number three, issues of in-laws and external influences. Money. Again, this money thing. The gospel is cheap, but it's expensive to take it to the lost. The body of Jesus was hanging on the cross. No prayer warrior could bring it down. No prophet. The prophets prayed Jesus from heaven to earth, but they could not pray Jesus from the cross to the tomb. No amount of intercession would take that body back, because the body was hung by a system that was antichrist. It took a man of wealth called Joseph of Arimathea. Your salvation that you are laughing as if it just happened in one small pit. Wealth, played a role in bringing the body of Jesus down to his virgin tomb, as a prophet said it would be, for salvation to happen. Are we together now? There are many people who have books that have been inspired by the Spirit that can change nations, and had visions, and the Lord told them, make sure these books get to the ends of the earth. But the book has not gone beyond their community for one singular reason: not revelation, not lack of prayer, resources. We have many people in the music ministry here. They will tell you the challenges that they face, that you have to stand for truth. It's a difficult thing. If you don't have anybody you are taking care of, this message will not make sense to you. The average person in Nigeria has at least 3 or 4 people depending on your obedience to God's principles to eat. Some of them are our parents. Where will I start teaching my father mystery of this and wealth and will he learn? And yet you are connected to them by blood. You cannot leave them that way. It's difficult to send our children to schools that subscribe to the value systems of the kingdom. And because of money, we will send our children to places that are devilish. The person teaching them does not have, you leave your children well cultured. They return back like cultists, because they were under the, and because you too, you are busy looking for money. When they come back, you are asleep. By the time they are ready to go to school, you are out already. That happens for 10 years. So the devil makes sure anything that represents light, the eyes of your child will not see it. And the tool is money. So the only mentors they have are people who do not represent the value system of the kingdom. There is a serious time bomb that we are programming and laughing at. And if we do not arise, a generation will come. This is why our teenagers hate God. The devil carefully grew with them. And right now their obsession is something else, not God. You off your television, he will switch it with his phone and continue watching what he's watching. You talk to him and he say, no, my rich uncle said this. And you stand there. How do you defend that statement? Remember, you are broke. Remember, you are poor. I was told about how much these people invest in sound just to have a concert. I couldn't believe it. I don't know how many houses you buy with that money. Is that true? If somebody comes to marry your daughter and tells you he's a child of God, he's born again, Jesus is Lord, he has been taught and mentored. As honest as you are, you hate to do it, but you have to ask him, so young man, how are you going to take care of my daughter? If he tells you, don't worry, is it not God we are talking about here? Do you know how many people have married outside God's will because of money? They knew that this brother is the will of God. But they said, you know how life is. This is not my fault. They even explained to him and said, we know we are supposed to be together. But the reality is, I can't, you didn't try for me. So I have to just get another person. And on the wedding day, she's smiling. Will you take this person? Yes, I do. She knows she's in trouble. But the family is depending on that as a breakthrough. How will I call on your name and end up in shame? How will I bow down before you and then bow down before a man?
Thank you for watching our entire video today. If you feel you can bless someone, please join us and spread the gospel by sharing this video on your social media.